Will there be Ice Age 6? Will global warming cause an ice age? Or are we living in an ice age? Scientists have recorded 5 significant ice ages throughout the Earth's history: the Huronian, 2.4 to 2.1 billion years ago, Cryogenian, 850 to 635 million years ago, Andean-Saharan, 460 to 430 million years ago, Karoo, 360 to 260 million years ago, and Quaternary, 2.6 million years ago to present. The earliest was over 2 billion years ago, and the most recent one began approximately 3 million years ago and continues today. Yes, we live in an ice age. Currently, we are in a warm Holocene interglacial, which began about 11,500 years ago. The middle of the Holocene was warmer than today, at least during summer in the Northern Hemisphere, due to changes in Earth's orbit changing the distribution of solar radiation received on Earth. Similarly, an interglacial or interglacial period is the warmer period of time between ice ages, where glaciers retreat and sea levels rise. Over the last 450,000 years, glacials have lasted anywhere from 70,000 to 90,000 years, whereas interglacials last approximately 10,000 years. So, in fact, the last ice age hasn't ended yet. Scientists call this ice age the Pleistocene Ice Age. It has been going on since about 2.5 million years ago, and some think that it's actually part of an even longer ice age that started as many as 40 million years ago. We are probably living in an ice age right now. The curious thing about ice ages is that the temperature of Earth's atmosphere doesn't stay cold the entire time. Instead, the climate flip-flops between what scientists call glacial periods and interglacial periods. Glacial periods last tens of thousands of years. Temperatures are much colder, and ice covers more of the planet. On the other hand, interglacial periods last only a few thousand years, and the climate conditions are similar to those on Earth today. We are in an interglacial period right now. It began at the end of the last glacial period, about 10,000 years ago. Scientists are still working to understand what causes ice ages. One important factor is the amount of light Earth receives from the sun. The amount of sunlight that reaches Earth can vary quite a lot, mainly due to three factors: how much Earth is tilted relative to the sun, whether Earth wobbles a lot or a little as it spins on its axis, kind of like how a toy top can wobble a lot or a little as it spins. The shape of Earth's orbit as it goes around the sun, whether it is shaped more like a circle or more like an ellipse or oval. Over thousands of years, the amount of sunshine reaching Earth changes by quite a lot, particularly in the northern latitudes, the area near and around the North Pole. When less sunlight reaches the northern latitudes, temperatures drop and more water freezes into ice, starting an ice age. When more sunlight reaches the northern latitudes, temperatures rise, ice sheets melt, and the ice age ends. But there are many other factors. So if you became a climate scientist one day, you could make your own discoveries. To find out more about Earth's climate in the past, scientists study ice cores. These samples tell us that during the current ice age, climate on Earth has flip-flopped between glacial and interglacial periods at least 17 times. So it is very likely that Earth will turn cold again, possibly within the next several thousand years. But we have to keep in mind that human activities today are impacting climate on a global scale. So when we predict future climate changes, including the next glacial period, we need to consider the changes that humans are causing. Researchers used data on Earth's orbit to find the historical warm interglacial period that looks most like the current one, and from this have predicted that the next ice age would usually begin within 1,500 years.